Radio KRAK.
Radio KRAK.
Kruševački.
Radioaktivistički kutak.
Projekat Interkulturalne kompetencije u omladinskom radu kreiran je u partnerstvu četiri omladinske organizacije iz Albanije, Grčke, Srbije i Crne Gore i uključuje učesnike iz još pet zemalja članica Saveta Evrope, Austrije, Bosne i Hercegovine, Hrvatske, Italije i Makedonije, a sa ciljem promocije različitosti, interkulturalnog dijaloga, zajedničkih vrednosti slobode i poštovanja ljudskih prava. Projekat je realizovan kroz sedmodnevni međunarodni trening kurs od 5. do 11. aprila 2019. u Kruševcu za učesnike iz 9 zemalja sa iskustvom ili sa posebnim interesovanjem za interkulturalno učenje, dijalog i razumevanje. Organizator međunarodnog trening kursa je Edukativni centar Kruševac uz podršku European Youth Foundation i Saveta Evrope.
Radio KRAK.
U okviru ovog projekta realizujemo i ciklus radioemisija, odnosno razgovora sa učesnicima treninga interkulturalne kompetencije u omladinskom radu.
Radio KRAK.
Maria Vekri from Greece is our guest in program online radio station KRAK. Maria, thank you for your time.
Thank you for inviting me.
You are a counselor for Ministry of Education in Greece. What is your area of expertise?
Actually, I started my career as an educator. I was a professor. And then after getting several master degrees in psychology, I became a counselor working for a counseling center nowadays in charge of students and young people in a certain area. A big area, actually, in Athens. Among the tasks, let's say, of mine is to let young people be self-aware of themselves and their strengths, character strengths, so that they get empowered to realize their dreams in life.
Is there your expertise have some connections with career development of young people?
Yes,
and
absolutely so.
Employability?
Yes, absolutely so. Because this is, let's say, one of our main aims, to make them employable, whatever it may mean. In the hard times we are going through. And we think that we have to start with knowing ourselves, which was one of the basic, let's say, values in ancient Greek philosophy, which I have studied as a first degree. That's why I am applying positive psychology principles. Positive psychology is a very interesting stream in psychology because you are not interested in the problems. You are interested in the problems, but you approach them in a different way, by letting people know about their strengths. Mm-hmm. There will never live a period without any problems. But if we know how strong we are,
problem is the challenge.
Exactly, exactly so. And it is an opportunity, as we may know.
Radio KRAK. Kruševački radioaktivistički kutak.
misliš? Kruševački radio aktivistički kutak.
Can you explain us, explain our listeners more about this center, counseling center in Greece? Share experience from your country.
It has started for me. It has started very long ago, when we didn't actually have those counseling centers in Greece. It was only after we entered the EU that we realized that we needed them in order to prepare our young people for their future and life. And it is not only responsible for young people, but for the whole community, let's say, because we organize interventions for them. For example, now that we had all these problems due to the crisis, you may have heard of that in Greece.
Yes.
We had a lot of programs about resilience in the community, how we can feel strong enough as a community and develop our social network, and so that we can support each other in order to survive. It has to do with life skills, survival skills, competencies, and this kind of stuff. It has to do with a greater community.
So, empower the whole community.
Exactly, exactly so. One more thing is that, as you may know, in Greece we have a lot of refugee flows nowadays. Yes. Which changed our realities. I mean, people were not prepared for such a change. We might be very good willing, but the situations can be hard sometimes. So we needed extra competencies. Given that the structures in our country were not prepared to receive all these new people, refugees. Here I would like to make the note that Europe has closed its border, and we were among the two countries who had received all these big flows of refugees. But we managed so far to host them and offer them the basic, let's say, the basic support. There are problems, and they are going to become more because they are still coming, and we put them in camps and this kind of things. But it was very moving that simple people, ordinary people, I'm not talking about NGOs, etc., etc., I'm talking about locals. We have opened their hugs, and they have offered them whatever they could, from clothes to food to solidarity. This solidarity thing is very important because, as we say in Greece, people are hungry for food, but they are thirsty for dignity. And I hope we have offered them a safe environment to feel humans again.
You talk about a strong local community. Can you tell me about cross-sectoral cooperation? I mean about cooperation between public, civic, and private sector.
Actually, it is one of the tasks of our center, this counseling center, as we said, because, for example, there was no any connection. There was no connection between the formal educational settings and the community or the private sector. Oh, yes, decision makers, exactly, stakeholders. This is what we are trying to bridge by bringing them together through common activities and projects. We organize such activities so that they meet, let each other to be heard, and start cooperating. This is one of our tasks. And it is interesting because we cannot do anything else but cooperate if we really want to have some solutions in these difficult social challenges.
Maria, thank you for your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Radio KRAK.
Osnovni cilj projekta interkulturalne kompetencije u omladinskom radu bio je snaživanje omladinskih radnika, odnosno radnica, kako bi se obezbedio interkulturalni dijalog, povećale mogućnosti mobilnosti interkulturalnog učenja i unapredile interkulturalne kompetencije mladih u omladinskom radu i neformalnom obrazovanju u Evropi. Podsjetit ćemo, organizator treninga je Edukativni centar Kruševac uz podršku European Youth Foundation i Saveta Evrope.
Radio KRAK.
Radio KRAK.
Kruševački.
Radioaktivistički kutak.